How can we see light from distant galaxies in a young universe? Some galaxies are billions of light years away. A light year is the distance that light travels at 300,000 kilometers per second for a year.
That's a long way.
It is. If we assume that there haven't been large-scale changes to the universe since creation, the light from those galaxies took billions of years to get to Earth. Since we can deduce from the Bible that God created everything about 6,000 years ago, how can we see that light? That's the question. I met a man a few years ago who thought that this question was insurmountable, so the Bible must be wrong, and he rejected Christ because of it. And now, when he told me this, he was a Christian because someone had showed him that there are biblically based models that can answer this challenge.
Now, some have suggested God created light in transit, but then that would mean things we see billions of light years away, like a supernova, never actually happened.
Yeah.
It makes God into some kind of a trickster, giving us illusions instead of reality.
Yeah. Now, there are better explanations, and some use Einstein's theory of general relativity.
Oh, no.
Now, don't worry. We can summarize without the need to understand all of Einstein's equations. He said that gravity distorts time. Where there's weaker gravity, like at the top of a mountain or on the International Space Station, further away from the center of the Earth, time moves faster than where gravity's stronger.
Now, take that bizarre but scientifically verified principle to Scripture. The Bible hints that the Earth is somewhere near the center of the universe and that the universe is not infinite.
Right, yeah. About a dozen verses in Scripture indicate that God stretched out the heavens. So before that stretching, and let's say that happened on day four when God created the sun, moon, and stars, before the stretching, everything in the universe was closer than it is now. So there have been large-scale changes to the structure of the universe. What are the relativistic effects of that?
Well, if all the matter was closer together and the Earth is in there somewhere near the center, then gravity around the Earth would be high,
right,
while far away from the Earth, at the edge of the universe, gravity would be low. And if there's a big difference in gravity, there's a big difference in the rate of at which time flows.
Yes. So it's possible that while billions of years elapsed at the edge of the universe, only hours ticked by on Earth, allowing enough time for the light from those galaxies to get to Earth. Different clocks in the universe at one time might have looked something like this.
So it's not light moving faster, it's time.
Yes, yeah, that's right.